Hi, welcome to the Emmy Within by Headline Steve. Thank you.
Nice to see you all here this evening. You found your way. We would like to introduce ourselves first. My name is Susie Payne, and I'm playing the role of Claire, William's cleaning woman.
My name is Colin Thomas. I'm going to be playing William, the Premier. I'm also going to be playing a lot of other characters, but when I am playing William, I'm going to be saying words that actually came out of the mouth of Bill Bennett. Okay, and just to warn you when those little gems are coming up, I'm going to make this sound.
We'd also like you to know that any references that we make in the show to government policy are factual. And the show runs about 1 hour in length. And what we'd like to do is ask you to take a short break and then join us for a breath of fresh air, I suppose. I don't think that there are any liquid refreshments of any sort this evening, sorry, but please take a short break and then feel free to come back and join us in a discussion about the issues that we raise in the show or about the show itself. We'd very much like to hear your feedback on it.
And my name is Pat Keating. I'm Headline Stage Manager. At one point during the production, I'm going to be coming into the audience, and I'd like you to help me to be a really big demonstration. Now, how we're going to do this is I'm going to have signs like this one here, and they're going to have slogans written on them. And when I hold them up, I'd like you to chant along with me the slogans written on them, okay? Maybe we can rehearse with this one here. So when I hold it up, just chant along with me the slogan written on it, all right? Here we go.
Start the show! 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 Start the show!
Hi, I'm Claire. I've been cleaning William's office for 7 years now. I have seniority here. Seniority and security. I love this job. I get bonuses, holidays, beautiful presents at Christmas, and the rest of the staff look up to me because I have the Premier's confidence. It's wonderful to be so close to someone of his stature. Ronald Reagan, Margaret Thatcher, William, and just look at him. Isn't he good looking? Doesn't he give you goosebumps? You know, I've kept a scrapbook of all the photos taken of William. All the articles written about him. All the important things that he's ever said. And all the notes that he's left for me. Oh yes, William and I are quite close.
I'm late. I'm late, oh boy, I'm late. Claire, Claire, I have you seen some papers, a speech.
Your address to the province?
Yes. I haven't been in front of the cameras in 5 minutes.
It's right here.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. This could be the most important speech of my career. I get so nervous. I can't keep my certs. My turds. My words straight. What if that awful Stan pesky person asks me hard questions?
Just look him straight in the eye and say the first thing that comes into your mind. You are the Premier. They have to listen to you.
You're right. First thing that comes into my mind, what does he know anyways? You're right. I am the Premier. They have to listen to me. Do you think we could practice? Let's play the Marjorie Nichols game, okay? You be Marjorie, and I'll be me.
And I ask you questions, and you say the first thing that comes into your mind.
Yeah.
Ready?
Shoot.
Mr. Premier, tell us about your trip.
I know. It's very nice to be here in Taiwan. No. That's not right. Try me again.
Listen to the question, William.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
Yesterday in the legislature, you said...
World recession, British Columbia stuck deep.
Oh, God, that's very good.
I'm on a roll, Claire, I'm on a roll. Try me again.
Mr. Premier, what are your plans for the...
I know this one. That's a good question. Huh, wait and see. no model to follow because no other government has accepted the challenge of living within the taxpayers' means.
Oh, that's good. That's very good. But you only have 2 minutes left.
Oh, my God. I'm late.
We'll fix your tie before you go on. See what I mean? Anyone who works as hard as he does, or who's so devoted to his principles, and he's under so much pressure. I was saying to Lulu just the other day, Lulu, now that's someone else you should meet. She's my closest friend here. Lulu just moved to Canada a little while ago from the Philippines. And she brought me this. Now she said that this was carved from a soup bone by someone who had been in prison. It has an inscription on the other side. Each dawn is a new beginning. Oh, Lulu! Lulu! Oh, she must be in Mr. Heinrich's office. It's the funniest thing. When you go in there, you can't hear a thing anyone else is saying to you. Lulu! Well, Lulu has been telling me the most awful stories about what it was like for her to work in the Philippines. She was in one of those export processing zones, working for Ford of Canada, no less. Now, Lulu said that these zones were wonderful for the companies that move in. They get tax write-offs and cheap rent and hydro and workers. Strikes are illegal, which isn't such a bad thing. I only joined a union myself because I had to work here. But Lulu said that she would work in this factory, doing the same monotonous job, day in, day out, sometimes 16 hours a day, making, what was it she said? $1.50 a day, even if she'd worked overtime. Now she said it wasn't enough to buy food or clothes. So one day, Lulu and some other people went on an illegal strike. Well, I don't believe in breaking the law. I told her so myself. But you know, within 12 hours or so of going on this strike, Lulu and 400 other people were arrested by the military, taken to jail, held for 18 hours without food or water. And she said that some of them were tortured. Now, I had always thought that the Philippines was a lovely country, a civilized country. I mean, they have elections, don't they? Well, that's what you read in the news. Well, anyway, she moved to Canada, and you'll meet her sometime. I should get back to work.
Goody.
Goody.
Tonight, I would like to talk to you about restraint.
Will you?
In British Columbia today, in 1983, one in three forestry workers is unemployed. One in four employees in other resource industries is jobless. And one in five persons employed in service and manufacturing industries is looking for work.
Lulu, come quick! Lulu is on the TV!
I believe that no one should be guaranteed a job for life when others don't enjoy the same advantage. The route to recovery is restraint.
You tell them, Billy.
Claire, please. British Columbia is like a big house. It is essential that we keep our house in order. Keeping our house in order means restraining our spending. It means being lean without being mean.
Oh, isn't he marvelous? Oh.
Our goals are firm and unshakable.
Thank you.
No sincere person can challenge their absolute necessity.
It's for me.
I'm confident that several years from now, we will look back in the knowledge that, difficult as it may have been, through leadership, with a framework of cooperation, we made our province a better place in which to live. Thank you, and good night.
Downsizing government services. You have the choice of severance pay or a waiting list.
being laid off.
It was terrific. Everybody said so. I was terrific. I showed them, boy. Of course, restraint is going to mean some temporary inconvenience for people like Claire, but that's okay. She can handle it. It was terrific. What did I do? Did you like it?
Is this some sort of joke?
No!
Oh, did I say something to offend you? Oh, that's it, isn't it? I've done something awful. I don't know what it is. Tell me what it is.
No, Claire!
What am I going to do? 7 years is a long time. I can't just pack up all my mops and my cleansers. I've gotten used to you, to the way you look. You didn't go on TV looking like this, did you,
Claire? Listen!
Does this mean we're never going to be able to see each other again?
Oh, no, Claire. You know me. I'm Mr. Nice, remember? I've got plans for us, Claire, big plans. Of course I do. I didn't want to have to lay you off. Jiminy, when I was in the private sector and I had to lay someone off, I'd lie awake worrying about it at night. But you have a mission. I am giving you a sacred trust, a new beginning. I want you to go out there into the province and compete. We've entered a new reality, Claire. It's time to provide new incentives that will increase efficiency and productivity. Employees must learn to be flexible, seeking wages and working conditions that reflect their shared interest in productive and competitive enterprises.
What about you and me?
Well, I'll be with you every step of the way. Efficiency, productivity, competition, free enterprise, you and me, the world stage layoffs expo!
William, well, I don't mean to appear ungrateful for the sacred trust you're giving me, but I'm still going to need a job.
Oh, job, no problem. Here, he's one of us, you know what I mean? Sort of family.
Mr. Groper.
Yeah, imagine, the two of us, Claire, the world stage. It's so exciting. Have a terrific day.
All right. Oh, well, I guess this is a new beginning. A new reality. A new life. Being a cleaning woman, anyway. You need a change. It's good for you. And William is right. We all have to pitch in. And if I can do my part by looking for a new job, then that is exactly what I'm going to do. It's never been difficult to find work. You just have to be positive and sell yourself.
Excuse me.
Excuse me, young man, what are you doing here?
Okay, folks, this is it. Just like we rehearsed it.
We want jobs!
I want jobs! You're that solidarity demonstration, aren't you? I read about you in the newspaper. Well, I think you haven't understood a few things, if you don't mind my saying so. The Premier has a vision for the future. There will be many jobs in British Columbia. You will be employed. You'd have to be patient. Now, I think if you paid him a little more respect and perhaps gave him a little more understanding, you wouldn't have to come to a demonstration like this tonight.
No restraint!
No restraint! No restraint!
No
restraint!
No restraint! Restraint is one of those things we're going to have to learn to live with. You have to tighten the belt buckle a few notches. Restraint isn't the problem. It's those people who don't think it's necessary.
General strike!
General strike! General strike! General strike!
That's very extreme!
Strike.
That is very extreme! Now, you're all special interest groups, aren't you? Well, this province will never be run by protests and rallies. And the Attorney General is going to clamp down on things like this. Do you know what he said? He said, we have come too far down the road in this country in the last 5 years of emphasizing people's rights and not their responsibilities. And he can change the laws if he wants to, you know. Now, if you don't like the way things are run, why don't you run for office? This is a democracy. Well, you may have nothing better to do but sit around. I have a job interview to go to.
Good evening. I'm pleased to announce that an avenue for resolving the labor difficulties in British Columbia has been reached. I had a lovely evening in Kelowna with Jack Monroe. My wife, Audrey, served cheese and crackers and antipasto, and the strikes are over.
Jack Monroe, and we were just getting started.
Stranger to the night, is drinking the lamp. Love is at first sight. What were the chances we'd be sharing love before the night was?
Mr. Grover? Oh.
Come in, come in.
I'm Claire. William sent me about a job. I'm sorry I'm late. There was this terrible scene outside. A demonstration. People shouting slogans.
Solidarity? Bad B. Seriously, you didn't join them.
Oh, no, of course not. In fact, I gave them a piece of my mind.
Not too big a piece, I hope.
Pardon?
Oh, nothing. Nothing. So you're looking for a job, eh? Well, what do you do?
Well, what have you got?
Not so fast, not so fast, Lily. There are a few questions I'd like to ask you first, if you don't mind.
Of course not.
First, though, you don't belong to a union, do you?
I do. I only joined in order to be able to get work. Oh, in fact, I don't really think they're necessary.
Oh, fine, fine, that's fine. Just as long as we understand each other, eh? Now, first question. Are you single?
Yes. I've never found the right person, I guess.
Good, good. Next question. Who'd you vote for in the last election?
William, of course.
Excellent. Excellent. Next question. What church do you go to?
What?
I like my employees to go to the same church as me, you know what I mean? It sort of keeps things in the family. Now, next question. What kind of birth control do you use?
You have no right to ask a question like that.
Right. It's my business. I have a right. What kind of birth control do you use? Abortions?
Who could report you for this? Asking those sort of questions is illegal.
I can ask you anything I like.
No, you can't. I'm going to report you to the Human Rights Commission.
Go right ahead. Well, you've removed it. It doesn't exist anymore.
That's a lie. He wouldn't do a thing like that.
Whoa. You're a spitfire, aren't you? I can't wait to see your sexy body.
Whoa!
Come to Papa! Come on!
I wouldn't work for you if you were the last person on Earth.
Hey, don't take it personally. I treat everybody like this.
Well, not me, you don't. You can take your job and you can stuff it.
Oh, fine. Fine, that's fine by me. Look, if you don't want to work for me, there are plenty of people who will. You just wait, you'll see.
I don't.
No, get out of here. Failed the physical, didn't you?
He had the last laugh, too. There really is no more Human Rights Commission. They replaced it with an appointed counsel. He can ask any kind of personal questions he wants, and there's nothing anyone can do about it. I know, because I tried. Do you know what the new Human Rights Counselor said? He said, it was Mr. Groper's habit to warmly greet his regular customers and his staff with a hug and a kiss on the cheek. In other words, he does treat everybody like that. I can think of someone who has some explaining to do. William, can I sit with you, please, William?
Oh, Claire, what is it? I mean, I'm a busy guy. I am building the Coca-Cola Highway here.
William, did you cut the Human Rights Commission? William, did you cut the Human Rights Commission?
Why?
Just yes or no.
Well, yeah.
Why?
It was costing taxpayers way too much money. We replaced it with something better.
But how much money are you spending on your highway?
Oh, jugs and jugs, probably more than $1 billion.
Well, where is all this money coming from?
What's with all the questions, Claire?
Well, do you think that's fair?
Fair? What's fair? It has to do with the taxpayers' ability to pay. In the new world economy, there will be survivors and there will be casualties, but there will be no special privileges. This is the new reality, remember?
But if you're spending all this money on your
enough,
house...
Enough! That's all the questions for today. You've had enough news.
William, I'm beginning to think that you care more about your highway than you care about me.
Claire, I care about you. Look, I mean, I know I've been busy a lot lately, but I'm doing it all for you. What do you think I'm doing up there on the Coca-Cola Highway?
What?
Well, I'm making jobs. I am making lots and lots of jobs.
I am not a highway worker.
That's true. But there's going to be a job for you. There are going to be jobs for everybody. I've got a plan. Claire, trust me. Okay. Okay, look, come on, look, I got something to show you. Look, look out there. What do you see?
People.
No. Use your imagination. Look, it's the entire Pacific Rim. There's the west coast of the United States, and Mexico, and Central and South America, the South Pacific, Thailand, and Korea, and the Philippines. British Columbia has the potential to become an intellectual Philippines. Papagueo said that. China and Japan and British Columbia. Gracie has called us the Pearl of the Pacific.
Oh, well, keep going.
Well, the Pacific Rim. BC Expo International Trade. That's the plan.
That's the plan.
Expo. It's going to bring some of the world's movable money to our shores, Claire, and I am going to keep it here.
Well, how are you going to do that, William?
With a whole new economic structure. And that includes special enterprise zones. Those zones mean less red tape, more tangible benefits, and a skilled and flexible workforce. Almost everybody who's working or who wants to work will benefit. It's time for BC to cut a slice of the pie, take the lead and attract the world. And we're starting in Delta.
I want to work, William. I want us to benefit together.
Oh, we will, Claire, we will. You will become part of a flexible workforce that will bring more international capital into the province, that will create more jobs, that will make us all rich. That's why I had to lay you off.
Oh, I understand. Oh, it's so exciting.
It is, isn't it? So exciting, we made a little film about it, actually. Special Enterprise Zones. It's available through the Department of Industry and Small Business Development. Now, what was it you wanted to ask me about?
Oh, well, doesn't matter. You've got a lot on your mind.
Good. Just remember, attitude is more important than facts. Have a terrific day.
Oh. Attitude is more important than facts.
Anybody? Anybody want to buy a balloon? They are great little balloons. Just wait till you see them. Look at this. Got Expo written all over it.
You do all sorts of things with them, too. You can, make rude noises. With a little practice, you could even play tunes on them. Just a second. Or you can blow them. Let's hope that's not an omen on the old expo grounds, eh? Should be able to play a tune on this. See if you can name this tune, okay? I've been working on it for a while. Anybody? Flight of the Bumblebees. Recognize it now, right? Right? You can also do balloon impersonations with these. Look at this. NDP think tank. Look at this one. Look at this. The political career of Dave Barrett. You know what I always say? It's time for BC to have more salesmen and better salesmen because we have a better product to sell. Which brings me to my point. $20. What do you say? Who wants a balloon for $20? Okay. Okay, for this crowd, 1988. Well, come on. That's a lot less than you're going to be paying for them on site. They are really good construction, made in Taiwan, no union problems. No. Okay. Okay, that's fine. Tell you what, you don't have to pay for them, all right? We can trade. You give me something, I'll give you a balloon free, straight across, okay? Okay, let's see. Who here is super fit? Who here is super fit and supernatural, BC? Who is a tennis player or a jogger, aerobics nut? Anybody put up your hand? One, thank you very much. So that means, let's see who's fit. This guy, look at this. Fitness plus. So you look like the kind of guy who doesn't need all those health insurance frills, right? I mean, like those hospitals that are open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, all year round. They cost me a fortune. So tell you what, I'll cut back on health services. You agree to it, you get a free balloon. What do you say? Okay, all right, I like this crowd already. Okay, let's see, who here, I know, who here is a parent? You know, like I'm a child? Who here has kids? Okay, so that means that you're not a parent, right? So you don't need all those things like school services, right? I mean, English as a second language classes, teaching foreigners how to talk like us, who needs it? Sexual abuse classes, cut them, okay? So you agree to it. I'll cut back on school services. You agree to it, say the word free balloon. What do you say? Come on, don't be shy. What do you say? Okay, sure, fine. Okay, she wanted it, I can tell. Okay, oh, this one is a surefire winner. Who here is a woman? Come on, confess, I know some of you are women. All right, so that means that you're not, right? You're a guy, right? Yeah. Are you sure about that? Good. We don't want to deal with any fine lines, you know what I mean? So just between you and me, excuse us for a minute, okay? Between you and me, you don't need Vancouver Transition House, do you? I mean, wife, battery, all that stuff is very expensive. So I'll privatize the place. You agree to it, you get a free balloon. What do you say? Okay, yeah, fine. Good luck on your way out. The point is that I have like hundreds of thousands of these things, all right? So we're gonna have to start to move them a little faster, you know what I mean? I'll tell you what, anybody who wants a free balloon, I'll give you a balloon. I will give you 5 free shares of brick. You'll vote for me in the next election, okay? How many hands do I have? Do you vote, honey? Forget it. As for the rest of you, where's your BC spirit? Tell you what, I have an offer you cannot refuse, all right? A free balloon.
There you go. It's yours. Free balloon.
Okay. Trust me. All you have to do is promise that you'll come through the gate at Expo. Will you do that for me?
Yeah, okay. Thanks very much. I am the premier.
Okay, good. Look, I know you're all going to be there. No matter what you think now, your curiosity will get the better of you. And you better be there. Because if you're not, that whole thing is going to bomb. And you know whose fault that's going to be, don't you?
Yours.
Not mine.
Before that demonstration. I don't know what came over me. I don't usually yell at people. It's just that I felt we were in competition somehow. You know, if you get what you want, I don't get what I want. All I want is a job. Oh, I'm so nervous. When I went to UIC, I was worried. I can't say I wasn't, but deep down I knew things would be fine because I paid into the system. I was looking for work. But I looked for work. I looked for work, and I looked for work. Do you know how many people are out there looking for work? Do you know how hard it is to get hired? A woman? My age? My qualifications? There was nothing there, so I gave up. And I would even have been willing to try something else, you know, go back to school and learn something new. But that costs too much money. And there don't seem to be as many classes as there used to be. And it's the feeling I'm not paying my own way. That's the worst. All my life I've paid my own way. I've done something useful. And now there's no work. And there's nothing to tell. The passage of time and friends just drift away. I used to see Lulu at work. Oh, I wonder how Lulu's doing. I hope she stays out of trouble. She was very angry when we were fired. What do you wear to welfare? What do they want to know?
Crime. If we suspect you of lying, we can cut you off immediately.
You cannot keep any earnings or gifts of money for your first 8 months, and you cannot refuse to work.
How much money will I get?
A single employable woman over 26, $375 a month.
But my rent is $275.
Well, you may have to move.
Oh, I've been in the same apartment building for 15 years.
Shelter allowance is $200 a month.
Well, that isn't enough.
Look, are you going to argue with me too? There are always the food banks.
Well, couldn't I just have a little more money?
Look, we applaud the efforts of the food banks, but we do not wish to take over their jobs, all right? Grace McCarthy said that, and she is the mother of Expo. No wonder you can't do happy everyone here.
You didn't have to be so rude. I am not a criminal. I don't lie. I didn't create this situation. It's not my fault. You know what it's like to have to budget? When the best day is one where nothing happens at all. Because no matter what it is, it's going to cost money. My rent is $275. My hydro is $25. Just to have a telephone is $12. And everyday things, like laundry soap, detergent, toilet paper, is another 15. And that leaves me with... $48 for food. I'm going to have to take his advice. Well, there's always been food banks and soup kitchens serving down and out. I'm not a down and out. I'm me. The food bank, Burrard and Nelson, in the middle of the financial district, but the lineup is in the alley, out of the way. I get to talking to a nice young man next to me. He looks about 35, sort of like a farm boy who's got dressed up, come to the big city. He says, hello. He seems normal. Why do I expect him to be smelly and drunk? He says, have you got a place to stay? Yes, I say, thank you. I'm sleeping in the park, he says. Well, what do you do when it rains, I say. Oh, I find a stairway or an open garage. I stay there till the owner kicks me out. We're lucky to have the food banks, I say. I haven't eaten in 2 days, he says. I steal cheese and salami out of grocery stores. Twice I've been caught, I asked them to arrest me. Why would you ask to be arrested, I say. Because it's dry in jail, the food is hot. They won't do it. Yesterday was Sunday and the stores were closed. Today my stomach hurts so bad, I try to walk it off, but it doesn't work. Why doesn't somebody just kill me, he says, and get it over with? What am I supposed to do? I put my arm around him. What? Where's everybody going? What? What? There has to be. There's nowhere else to get any food. They turned away 200 people. I wasn't there early enough, I guess. Not their fault.
Expo bums!
There wasn't enough food.
Expo bums! Get your Expo bums here! Buy an IA at Expo souvenir!
Excuse me, I was wondering if you could tell me.
That's all right. You want to buy an Expo bum?
No, thank you. I was hoping you could tell me. What are those?
Expo bums. These are the little people The displaced people. These are the people that Expo is crushing under its great big feet. See, I have little old men from downtown Eastside hotels, and I have a nice selection of small business people. You want to buy one? I made it myself.
Oh, I don't have any money.
Oh. Expo bums! Get your Expo bums here!
Archie, I was hoping that you could help me. I don't have any food, and the food bank just...
Looking for money? Been to welfare?
Yes.
They just give you the runaround there, right? Oh, it's a terrible place. I know, it's a terrible place.
Oh, I suppose you're down on your luck, too.
Yeah. Well, what do you think I'm doing this for, lady? Expo bum! Buy an I Hate Expo souvenir!
I shouldn't have bothered you.
I used to have money. I used to have money before. Oh, boy, I had lots of money.
I understand.
I used to be a small businessman, just like this little guy. I used to be in fences. I used to build fences, like all over. I wire fences, like security fences, you know? But you know what happened? You know what happened to me?
What happened?
Well, I went under, didn't I? It wasn't my fault either. I ran it really good. Then the government came. The government. And they were going to have a buy in BC policy, right? Buy in BC. And they were going to build fences all along the ART system. You know what the train did that? Fences all the way from New Westminster to right underneath the Hudson's Bay Company. I could have been rich. But you know what they did? Instead of buying fences from me, you know where they bought them from? From the Israeli military.
From Israel?
Yeah, from way over there. How's that for a kick in the teeth? So I wish I could help you, lady. But it's the government, and they don't do a thing, those guys. They sure don't. They don't do a single thing.
Well, they are trying.
No.
Oh, yes. I used to be a government employee, actually. I'm quite familiar with how the government works.
You are in the government? In what capacity would that be?
Well, I used to be a cleaning woman.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's good work, eh? That's steady work. You know those guys over there?
I used to work for the Premier. Seems like a long time ago now.
You work for the Premier?
For William. Yes. I used to be his confidant.
Whoa, boy! So I guess you gave him a piece of your mind, didn't you? I guess you told him what you thought about what he did down here, eh? Well, what he did with solidarity and all that? Boy, I couldn't believe that. We were sold right down the river. He don't care, you know. He don't care about you. He don't care about me. He don't care about nobody.
I think you're exaggerating. William is a very busy man.
Oh. Well, he fired you, didn't he? Why does he care about you? You stay here!
You're possibly mistaken.
You can stay here!
You can't just be on my way.
You can't just walk out in the middle of a discussion.
I'm very sorry. I didn't mean to offend you.
Oh, nobody cares about nobody no more.
I haven't done anything to hurt you.
Oh? What did you do when you had the chance, eh? What did you do when you used to work for him?
I wasn't in a position to do it.
What did you do? Did you ever say anything to him?
Well, I...
No. No. Because you didn't care, did you? Not until you were in the same boat as everybody else. We're all in the same boat now, and we're all sinking together, aren't we, sister? Oh, forget it. Forget it. I was just a statistic to him, and I'm just a statistic to you. I'm just another bankruptcy. Just another lunatic on the street. Just selling souvenirs on the street. Just yelling on the street. La, 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 la.
I'm very sorry. What am I supposed to do?
You say hi to your boss next time you see him. You say hi to him for me. He won't know who I am. I'm just another bankruptcy. You say hi to him for me and all the other expo bums. We hope he starves to death. Expo bums! Get your expo bum here! Bye-bye, expo!
One year ago, I wouldn't have seen that man on the street. 1 year ago, I wasn't in this sinking ship. How can this be happening in the middle of all this wealth? In the middle of all these billion-dollar buildings? People become invisible, don't they? It's easy to look through people on the street. I'm not invisible, am I? I still have hands and arms and legs and a body. I just don't have any money.
Motion, 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 man, motion, 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 man, motion, 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 man. Claire!
Hello, William.
How are you doing?
Well, not too good, actually.
Oh. Why aren't you at the party? Big preview party for Expo. 200 journalists from around the world. Cocktails, wonderful food, fireworks. $500,000 party, and worth every penny of it.
I wasn't invited.
Well, that's too bad. Nice sea air, eh? Blow it in from the Pacific.
William, about Expo, actually.
It's our promise that we can produce an exhibition of unparalleled qualities being heard around the world. You want a bet?
No.
Ah, come on, you remember. Motion, motion, motion.
I don't want to dance.
All right. All right, I know what your problem is. You're not thinking positively enough. You need to get involved. Look, why don't you come on down to Jimmy's office? There's lots for you to do. You know, we did a lot of help down there.
Oh, can I get a job?
Well, not a paying job, exactly. But Expo belongs to all of us, Claire. We need lots of volunteers.
I need a job, William. I need to earn money.
Did you use the provincial day of prayer on April
6th? What?
I didn't think so. We were all supposed to pray for renewal and prosperity and repentance. But you didn't do your part, did you? That's okay. We have a religion pavilion on site. 100 Huntley Street, just like on TV. You bring some friends along, it'll make you feel better.
I don't want to go down to Expo, William. I can't afford to go down to Expo. I don't have $20. I can't afford to get on a bus. William, I need your help right now.
Oh, I'm trying to help you. What do you think all this is about?
William, I need a job. I need cash. Cold, hard cash. I can't eat Expo. I'm begging you. I'm hungry.
Well, I don't have any money. I don't have the ability to give you any taxpayers' money, Claire. And if it's charity you want, I'm sorry, but I gave in Kelowna.
Where are you going?
I am going back to Expo where I'm appreciated. Unfortunately, Claire, there are still people disparaging. Talking negatively, always talking about people's needs, always talking about problems and never offering solutions. Well, I am interested in people who have solutions, not in people who have problems. Tony Brahmett said that, and he's a cabinet minister.
William, come back, William, come back here! All right, you bastard! Ability to pay. Maybe I shouldn't have the ability to pay my taxes. What will happen to your party then? He's so damn generous. You know, he used to give me chocolates for Christmas. Beautiful chocolates. You know what we got the last year I worked there? Cooking apples. Think I'm joking? He brought in cartons of cooking apples, and we each got to pick 10. How's that for generosity? I need a drink. You don't clean someplace for 7 years and not know where things are kept. In this country. Now, why is that? There's lots of natural resources, lots of wealth, lots of money. It's because they're such generous bosses. They give you bonuses and holidays and Christmas presents, and they pay you $3.75 an hour. You can be working full-time in this province and not make enough to live above the poverty line. I know these things. I used to work here. Lulu says it doesn't matter what country you're in, you can never trust the bosses. Lulu. All those stories she used to tell me. I never believed her about working in export processing zones in the Philippines. About hundreds of women lining up day after day for the same job. Doing anything to get work. To get food. Armed guards in the factories. She used to say to me, she'd say, we were wasted like rags. After they used us, we were thrown away like rags. Oh, is it so different here? In BC, in the Pearl of the Pacific Rim, we may not have armed guards in the factories. There sure are a lot of us wasted rags. And how do they keep getting away with it, Lulu? How do the bosses keep getting away with it? Look at him. He's always smiling. He has just the right image for a leader. The premier. Well, he has to work at it. Let me tell you. I know these things. I used to have the premier's confidence. In the last election, they had to bring in a fellow to help William with his image. Does the name Patrick Kinsella mean anything to you?
Yeah.
Oh, I could probably find something on him in here if you've got a minute. This is it. Well, it was 1981. This Mr. Kinsella came here from back east to help market William. That's election talk. It means to get us all to vote for him. That's what he had to say. This is it. We can move you. He means all of us when he says this. We can move you to do something you may not have agreed is a logical thing to do. We developed a strategy to market the premier on the basis that in these tough economic times, we needed a tough guy leading us. That was the beginning of what we now know of as restraint. These are Mr. Kinsella's own words. And what that means is that they invented restraint to make William look tough, so we'd all think he was Lorne Greene in pulp form. Well, it worked. They fooled everybody. Did you vote for him?
No.
Did you vote for him? No. None of you voted for him. Somebody did. I did. Why did I vote for him? I guess I thought he was strong, that he cared for me. Pretty stupid, eh? The only reason I never said anything and why I kept going, because I thought William cared for me. Well, he didn't care. The system doesn't care. It's just greedy. Wants to make money. It just wants to chew you up and spit you into a special enterprise zone. Well, I am not going to become part of a flexible workforce in a special enterprise zone. A wasted rag. I wonder how he's going to explain this to Marjorie Nichols.
Good evening.
Good evening.
3 years ago tonight, I spoke to you on television about the deepening crisis in our economy. As your preview, I had a duty to lay the cards on the table. Tonight, I will be just as frank.
It's too late for apologies, William.
I'm pleased to say that... Claire! What are you doing here?
What does it look like, stupid?
Claire, don't do it, not now!
Give me one good reason not to!
Restraint is over! Listen, our program of partnership for economic renewal is new and exciting. With our tough adjustments behind us...
Partnership?
Yes, partners! Our crown corporations, our hospitals, our school districts, we have enormous
potential. Renewal! Why don't you tell the truth, William? You don't mean we, you mean you, don't you? And you don't mean renewal either. You mean people like me, working for really cheap, for people like you.
Claire, the real credit for our success belongs to you. Your willingness to make sacrifices. Your acceptance that what we did had to be done.
I don't accept that what you did had to be done, William. I don't accept that at all. Why don't you just shut up? Mr. Premier, do you have any plans to solve the current economic situation?
The Coquihalla Highway, the new Onassis Bridge, the exciting LRT system. These are the key components.
Same old girls. I'll give you another try. What are you going to do for all the people down at the food banks?
I care and feel deeply for those who still face difficulties. I know the past few years have been difficult for individuals, for families, and for businesses. The human costs are all too evident.
Yeah, I forgot. You gave in Kelowna, didn't you? I'll give you one more chance, William. Do you have any plans to get us out of this mess at all?
Yes! The most exciting investment of all, Expo 86. It will be a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to display ourselves to visitors. A chance for each and every BCer to stand up and say,
Expo bums, get your I Hate Expo souvenirs right here.
That does it. I am coming right down.
He's not going to sweet talk me again. Not without a fight.
Thank you.
much.
Thank you.
Well, we'd like to take that break we talked about, and then please do feel free to join us in a short discussion period. We'd like to point out also that there is a very small jar at the door, but it's capable of holding a fair amount of money.
You put in large bills.
Yeah. That donation jar is our only source of support for this work, so we very much appreciate any contribution you can make. If you missed it on the way in, one of our people can help you find it on the way out. Thank you very much.
If you're used to going to the theater, think of it in terms of a regular theater performance, and if you just go to movies, think of it as a movie with sweat. we'd also like to thank Joanne Hunter, who contributed.
Joan.
We'd like to thank Joan Hunter. Joanne can take care of herself. Thanks. She helped a lot with getting this evening's performance online. And we'd also like to ask you to tell people about tomorrow night's performance, okay? It's going to be our last one, and the publicity has had to be pretty rushed. So if you have friends who would like to see the show or should see the show, send them along.
It's here at the same time. Thank you very much. Please do come back. I wouldn't mind, but